guys, this is Vijay, chemistry lecturer from Alibaba Junior College. So as you know that we have started our NEET series, so based on that category we are discussing about each and every chapter in detail, and followed by we are practicing few numericals, right? So today in this session we are going to discuss about the same first unit, some basic concept, NCERT solution. So let us go for the next question, 34. A welding fuel gas which contains carbon and hydrogen only, burning a small sample of it in oxygen which gives 3.38 gram carbon dioxide, 0.690 gram of water and no other products. A volume of 10 liter which is measured at STP, standard temperature and pressure, of this welding gas which is found to weigh, its weight around 11.6 gram. Now let us calculate empirical formula, molar mass of the gas, molecular formula. Okay, let us see how to solve this. Question number 34. Okay, so first one is 1 mole of carbon dioxide which contains 12 gram of carbon. Yes. So 1 mole is nothing but what? 44 gram. Yes. So in the compound there are two different elements are there, carbon and oxygen. Oxygen number of atoms are 2. So 16 into 2, 32. 32 plus 12, 44 gram. Understood? So that means number of carbon atom present in 1 mole of carbon dioxide, that is 12 gram. So that is 12 by 44 into 3.38 gram given in the question. O2 which contain number of carbon, that is, simplifying this we will get 9217 gram, 0.9217 gram. So this is what? 3.38 gram of carbon dioxide which contain number of carbon. Now similarly we are going to find the water. 18 gram of water which contain 2 gram of hydrogen. Yes, in the compound you see two different elements are there, hydrogen and oxygen. Yes, oxygen is one molecule, 16. Hydrogen is also one molecule. One molecule into number of atoms are 2, 1 into 2, so 2 gram of hydrogen. Yes, and 2 gram of hydrogen plus 16, that is together 18 gram. Okay, so this is 18 gram of H2O which contain 2 gram of hydrogen. Now 0.690 gram of water will contain number of hydrogen, that is given in question. 0.690 gram of water H2O which contain number of hydrogen we are going to find, that is nothing but 2 gram, yes, divided by 18 into 0.690. simplifying this we will get 0.0767 gram. So this is what? Number of hydrogen present in 0.690 gram. Okay, this is what? Number of carbon present in 3.38 gram of carbon dioxide. In the question it is very clearly mentioned that the carbon and hydrogen are the only constituent present in the compound. So both the values we have to add. So what we have got for carbon, what we have got for hydrogen, that is adding these two, we will get 0.9984 gram. Now let us find the percentage of carbon present in the compound. This is the overall compound. Yes, carbon and hydrogen, overall the compound molecular mass. So overall mass of this carbon and hydrogen, that is 0.9948 gram, 0.9984 gram. That means percentage of carbon we are going to find. Percentage of carbon, let us find percentage of carbon, that is 0.9217 gram, that is nothing but the mass of, I mean, carbon present in the given value, and this is the overall value. So applying this 0.9984 gram into 100, simplifying this, we will get the percentage of carbon present in the overall compound, that is 92.32%. Number of carbon, percentage of carbon present in the compound. Similarly, we are going to find for hydrogen. Yes, percentage of hydrogen present in the compound. Hydrogen value is here 0.0767 gram divided by overall mass value is here 0.9984 gram into 100. Simplifying this, we will get the percentage of hydrogen. Percentage of hydrogen is 7.68%. So this both percentage should be tally. Now 92.32% plus 7.68%, that is overall 100%, the total compound present. Okay, these are the two different elements. Now we have got the percentage of carbon and percentage of hydrogen. Okay, so carbon percentage we have got and hydrogen percentage present in the compound also we have got, that is 92.3 to 7.68. We know percentage. So whenever we are going to find the empirical formula or molecular formula, first what we supposed to do, we should first write the composition of the given element present in the compound. So percentage first we have written, we have considered. Next we are going to find the number of moles present in the compound. Okay, so moles of carbon present in the compound. Okay, so we know the molecular mass of carbon, that is 12. That means the we have got the value for carbon present in the compound, that is 92.32 divided by carbon, that is 12. So simplifying this, what we will get? Moles of carbon present in the compound, that is 7.69 moles of carbon present in the compound. Similarly, we are going to write the moles of hydrogen present in the compound. Okay, moles of hydrogen first what we supposed to take? Percentage 7.68 moles, that is 1 7.68, that is what moles of hydrogen present in the compound. Now let us take the ratio for this both. Yes, moles of carbon present in the compound, that is 7.69 is to moles of hydrogen present in the compound, that is 7.68. so both are 1:1 ratio, 1:1 ratio. That means we have got the empirical formula ratio. So empirical formula, already we know that the compound contain only two elements, carbon and hydrogen. So applying this value, that means carbon is 1, hydrogen is 1. So the empirical formula would be CH is the empirical formula. So by this way we can find the empirical formula of the given question. Now let us go for the second question from this question number 34. Okay, so the second question, weight of 10 liter of the gas which is at STP, standard temperature and pressure, that is 11.6 gram. Applying this value, weight of 22.4 liter of the gas at STP, let us find weight of 22.4 liter at STP, standard temperature and pressure of the gas, that is 11.6 by 10 liter into 22.4. So simplifying this, we will get around 25.986 gram something. Okay, so this could be written as 26 gram, 25.9, so that is nothing but 26 gram. So the molar mass of the given gas we can find by this way. Now, empirical formula mass, how we are going to find? Let us see the third question. So, empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass, that is equal to, we have got the compound empirical formula, that is CH. Okay, so carbon, that is 12, hydrogen, that is 1, so 12 plus 1, 13, so 13 gram is nothing but empirical formula mass. Now N is equal to finding the molecular mass, molar mass of the gas divided by empirical formula mass. Empirical formula mass. Okay, molar mass of the gas. Molar mass of the gas, that is 26 gram. Okay, empirical formula mass, that is 13 gram. Simplifying this, we will get 2 gram. Simplifying this, we will get 2, because gram also cancelled. So the N value, that is N is equal to 2. Yes. So the molecular formula of the given compound, we know that the empirical formula, that is CH. The molecular formula, how we should write then? C, carbon is 2 and hydrogen is also 2. So this could be the molecular formula of the given compound, and CH is the empirical formula of the given compound. So by this way we can solve this problem. Let us go for the next question. So question number 35. Calcium carbonate which react with aqueous HCl to give CaCl2 calcium chloride and CO2 carbon dioxide. According to this particular reaction, CaCO3 calcium carbonate plus 2HCl which gives CaCl2 plus CO2 plus H2O. So this is the given equation. What mass of calcium carbonate is required to react completely with 25 ml of 0.75 molarity of HCl? So let us see how to solve this problem. So the amount of HCl present in 25 ml, that is 27.375 gram divided by 1000 ml into 25 ml. So simplifying this, we will get around 0.6844 gram. 0.6844 gram. Simplifying this, we will get. From the given chemical equation, let us look at that chemical equation. 2 mole of HCl, if you see the question, you can easily understand. 2 mole of HCl which is reacting with 1 mole of calcium carbonate. 2 mole of HCl reacting with 1 mole of calcium carbonate. So 2 mole of HCl reacting with 1 mole of calcium carbonate, that is 100 gram. Okay, so the amount of calcium carbonate that will react with, amount of CaCO3 that is reacting with, what we have got the value, that is 0.6844 gram, which is equal to 100 by 71 into 0.6844 gram. Simplifying this, we will get around 0.9639. So simplifying this, finally we will get the answer 0.9639 gram. So by this way we can solve this problem. Okay, so let us go for the next question. Question number 36. Look at this question. Chlorine which is prepared in the laboratory by treating manganese dioxide MnO2 with aqueous HCl, according to the reaction is given 4HCl plus MnO2 which gives 2H2O plus MnCl2 then Cl2. How many grams of HCl which is reacting with 5 gram of manganese dioxide? Let us see how to solve this. So in the entire reaction, if you see, 1 mole of MnO2 which gives 4 mole of HCl. So 1 mole of MnO2, that is nothing but manganese dioxide. So manganese dioxide molecular mass 55 plus 2 into 16. Similarly, 4 mole of HCl. So that is nothing but 4 into 36.5. Okay, so that is equal to 146 gram. Okay, 1 mole of MnO2, which is always, which gives 4 mole of HCl. Okay, now 5 gram of MnO2 will react with, let us see. 5 gram of MnO2 react with, okay, so applying the values 146 divided by 87 gram into 5 gram, so this is nothing but 146 is the molecular mass of HCl, 4 mole of HCl, 87 is nothing but 1 mole of MnO2. Okay, this simplification, simplifying this we will get 8.4 gram of HCl, 8.4 gram of HCl. Okay, so that means 8.4 gram of HCl will react completely with 5.0 gram of manganese dioxide, MnO2. So by this way we can solve this problem. Okay, yes guys, so far we have completed thoroughly the NCERT solutions of unit 1, some basic concept based on this NEET preparation. In detail we have discussed. Okay, I hope so that this will help you for your further preparations. Thank you for your support guys. Thank you.